So I wanted to talk today about a potential way Sony could get a sixth Underworld film off the ground. Let's get into it.
Hey YouTubers, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell over by the subscriber button to notify you every single time I upload. So if you're new to the channel, I want to just say that we have discussed this before. You know, the idea that we might potentially get an Underworld 6 sometime in the near future. Of course, Kate Beckinsale has come out and said that she is absolutely done playing the role of Celine. She feels like she's getting too old for the role and she's already been there, done that type of thing. She wants to move on with her career. That's totally fine. I completely understand that. And personally, I think it's time to move on from her character anyway. We've gotten her from a death dealer to one of the elders who's taken over her own little coven area. She's secluded. She's gone through her entire journey. Michael at this point, you know, spoiler warning, but Michael at this point is dead. Her daughter is fully grown. She can take up the mantle and we can actually go on from there. But I know a lot of fans think that Kate Beckinsale needs to be in the movie, or at least Celine herself needs to be in any continuation of this movie or this franchise. Of course, Lynn Wiseman has also talked about very recently, within like the last year or so, that they are still developing an Underworld television series. We don't know a whole lot about it yet, besides him saying that it's going to be different from the movie. It's going to be a little bit more mature, a little less dark, and you know, more so slated for television or streaming service, wherever it might actually end up. Personally, I would really love to see the Underworld television series more than the movie. I feel like this is a really unique world. They can expand it in a really awesome way. And as I said in my most recent Underworld video, I would like for them to take the initiative to do their own dark universe, that failed project with The Mummy and Tom Cruise and everything from Universal just last year, and do their own thing with the Underworld franchise. Don't just rely on vampires and werewolves, but bring in other classic movie monsters like Frankenstein, The Mummy, all of these other things that they can bring in to expand this world and make it better. But if they have to do a sixth Underworld film, what would it be about? How would they actually do it? Well, I'm not really sure what it's going to be about. As I said, they can really expand the world, bring it in. I think if they're going to do it, they need to bring back the human beings hunting the vampires and the werewolves from the fourth movie, something they completely ignored in the fifth movie, back to the forefront, especially with Celine's daughter, as she goes to place, mission to mission, trying to figure out more about the history or heritage or whatever, maybe throw in a love story there with some kind of Frankenstein monster type of deal, kind of like a Celine and Michael relationship between her and that monster. I mean, there's just so many different possibilities. One thing that really grasped my imagination after I watched Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse with the Miles Morales story, complete animation. We've seen live action Spider-Man movies for a very long time with the Sam Raimi trilogy, those two failed Amazing Spider-Man with Mark Webb directing, Andrew Garfield and Emma Stone. And then also we have the new MCU Spider-Man that's been in about like, what, three movies at this point? Gonna be five within the next year? I mean, heck, that's crazy. We've had a lot of live action Spider-Man movies, but going in to see Into the Spider-Verse was quite an experience for me, and I'm sure a lot of other people. It was the best way to capture Spider-Man, I think, on screen since ever. I mean, you get to see pure comic book coming to life with what they did in that movie, and it was absolutely spectacular. And I think, for the most part, Sony Animation Studios, they have proven themselves capable of making quality animated content for not very expensive. I mean, at least not in the same ballpark as something like Pixar or Disney or people like DreamWorks or maybe even Illumination, who does try to keep it cheap. You know, that is to be said. I think Sony and Illumination are usually on the same par with how much they want to spend with their animated movies, and it really does end up paying well for them. So at this point, not to go into too much box office information, but at this point, Into the Spider-Verse has made about $42 million that they've reported. Of course, we're going to be getting Wednesday numbers, at least at the time of recording this, sometime very soon here. So just going to ballpark $45 million domestically, $62 million to $65 million worldwide. So it's going to end up making enough money, maybe even domestically, to pay for its production budget, which was a reported $90 million. It's also been speculated that Sony spent $130 million on advertisements and just simply marketing the movie, which means they have a whole lot of faith in it. They think it's going to make a lot more money than that, and I'm not going to be surprised if it actually does. It's a fantastic film. It opened up in a really awesome time of the year where movies tend to have longer legs, and we're going to have to wait and see how much it really makes. But it has a lot of competition with Bumblebee and Aquaman and Mary Poppins even. I mean, seriously, it's going to have to prove itself despite being a fantastic film. But award season buzz, I personally think it deserves best animated feature over something like what? The Grinch or Incredibles 2 or something else like that. We're just going to have to wait and see. Personally though, getting back to the point, it would be awesome for Sony to put together a small animated sixth movie in the Underworld franchise with Celine, with all the characters that we know and love, not having to bring back the actors, but maybe for voice acting work if they want to come back, or maybe just getting someone who sounds like them so we can see the continuation of their story in the best way possible. Of course, this wouldn't even be the first time that the Underworld franchise went in an animation route, because if most fans remember, I'm not sure how many people actually remember this, but in 2011, there was released three little mini animated stories called Endless War, where it saw Celine hunting down three werewolves over the course of well over a century. And it really just kind of culminated into Michael and her right before the events of Underworld Awakening. So yeah, like, there is precedent here, at least in my opinion, to do an animated version of the Underworld franchise and bring back a lot of these characters. Honestly, I think this is the best version of what we could hope for as fans of this franchise. We are dealing with people who are not supposed to be aging, people who theoretically will not come back for one sequel or the other. A lot of people have been saying that Michael was treated poorly over the last couple sequels because they couldn't get Scott Speedman to come back. I mean, I guess I understand that he didn't want to come back and they needed to figure out what to do with his character, so they essentially just killed him off on screen with a body double. So it didn't really make a lot of sense for people and it was kind of a little underwhelming. But if they brought back the franchise in an animated format, it'd be easier to bring back people like Michael and Celine and their daughter and everybody else that we've seen throughout this entire franchise and be able to expand the story that way. And it doesn't have to cost a whole lot either. I mean, I honestly, Into the Spider-Verse cost $90 million, as I said. Usually they spend around 70 to 85 million or so with the Hotel Transylvania movies, but Sausage Party for Sony only cost $19 million. Don't think it needs to cost that little, especially with all of the really bad reports that came out with Sausage Party during that part of the year. So I'm not really sure. Maybe bringing a movie together for about $35-40 million, which is around the same range as Rise of the Lycans and also Blood War, would be pretty epic. You can have these characters back. You don't have to spend a ton of money, and you know you have at least enough of a market to get that initial budget back. Maybe even more so if you make it stylized and is fun as something like Into the Spider-Verse. Just gonna throw it out there. This is the way I would really like to see Underworld 6 in the theaters, if we're ever going to get it. Of course, you could also do the spin-off movie, as I said, or do something else entirely. Guys, would you like to see, or would you pay to see, the sixth Underworld film as an animation, or does it have to be live action with the actors that you want? Tell me in the comment section below. Do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that bell over by the subscriber button to notify you every single time I upload. It's been real.